If you are a gamer, you have probably already seen some stuff about DLSS from Nvidia and FSR from AMD, which in short seek to improve gaming performance through upscaling. Upscaling is the process of increasing the resolution of an image, and is used everywhere, especially in softwares for viewing and manipulation in images or videos, including your web browser. For example, if you watch a 360p video in full screen, unless you have a very low resolution screen, the image needs to be stretched to fill the screen space. Otherwise, you would have a small little window showing the video. There are several ways to do the upscaling. The three most traditional are nearest neighbor. It takes the color of the nearest pixel. Bilinear makes linear interpolations between neighboring pixels. And bicubic calculates cubic interpolations between neighboring pixels. Wonderful. As we say in Brazil, this is papaya with sugar. Any software, even your monitor, can make these types of interpolation. Now, what Nvidia and AMD are doing is a bit more elaborate. In the case of DLSS, Nvidia explicitly uses AI, where models are trained with high-resolution in-game footage. AMD, on the other hand, only states that it uses a state-of-the-art spatial upscaling algorithm, without mentioning AI. Contrary to DLSS, FSR is open source. I don't understand much of the subject, but if you are interested, you can take a look at the code and try to understand it or even use it on your own project. The only problem with those technologies, at least for now, is that they are only available for very few games. And the worst, in the case of DLSS, just for RTX cards, you know, the ones that are the hardest to find and stupidly expensive to buy. Then I thought, could I do something similar using Python? Well, with the OpenCV library, this is relatively simple, because the full version contains a module for upscaling with neural networks. But we still need to provide an upscaling module. You can try to train your own, but this is a laborious and time-consuming process, especially if you do not have a good GPU to start with. So, I'm going to use the FSRCNN-small module, which has nothing to do with AMD's FSR. It stands for Fast Super Resolution Convolutional Neural Network, and it is the fastest model I could find. It was made available by Zafke on GitHub, and has versions to increase the resolution by 2, 3 or 4 times. Keep in mind that the number of pixels increases with the square. That is, if I use the X2 model, it increases the width and the height of the image by 2, which means 4 times more pixels. I'm going to do the tests with the 4 times upscaling, which means 16 times more pixels. So to get a 1080p image, I just need an input at 480 by 270 pixels. I will test the upscaling on The Witcher 3. So I changed the game resolution to run at 270p and placed the little window on the corner of the screen. With the MSS library, I then captured that portion of the screen and feed it through the model. After that, I showed the result in full screen. As you can see, the process is utterly slow, with an average of 7 or 8 frames per second. And that's for the fastest model I could find. I tested some other models, but for some I got 1 frame every few seconds. I know, horrible. One of the reasons it is so slow is overhead, because we have to capture the frame on the screen and then start processing. Ideally, we would incorporate the upscaling directly into the game, similarly to the DLSS and FSR approaches. If only we could modify a game like that. Pytracing Maze. The game I made in Python and runs in low resolutions. Here I can easily implement the upscaling, right after rendering a frame and before displaying it. Thanks to dynamic resolution, we can run the game at 60 FPS. However, the resolution falls significantly and the end result is blurry. By turning off dynamic resolution, we see that the frame rate falls to about 1/3, and there's still a bit of blur in the resulting image. That's because the standard upscaling is done by nearest neighbor, and I still prefer that one for this game. Going back to The Witcher 3, to simulate a more ideal case, I recorded a clip of the game at 270p and then upscaled it. Now we are able to compare the bicubic with the neural network scaling. The difference is subtle. The image from the neural network seems to have a bit more contrast and less aliasing. but it is not significantly better. This shows that the chosen model is not the best, but the best models take a few seconds to do the upscaling of a single frame, so a clip of a few minutes could take several hours to be processed. So this is the point where we lose all our hopes? Never. Coincidentally, while I was doing the tests for this video, the version 0.52 of the Magpie application was launched, which includes upscaling with the FSR method, besides other algorithms. It captures the content of any window, upscales it, and displays it in full screen. That is exactly what I was trying to do, only much better. The only problem is that the application is in Chinese, but it is very easy to use. Just open the application, select the upscaling method, and if you want, mark the checkbox to display the FPS. The key combination is used to activate and disable the upscaling. To activate it, you have to have the game window in focus and simply press the key combination. Of course, the game needs to be running in windowed mode to work. And man, it works really well. The impact on performance is reasonable. By my test, it is around 10% less FPS when upscaling from 720p to 1080p, at least while using the FSR method. Running the game with the same settings at 1080p has a performance hit of about 30%. Of course, the quality will not be equal to native resolution, but it certainly looks better than running the game in 720p full screen. To my eye, it seems to approach 900p quality, but for that resolution there's a 20% drop in performance. Of course, these are not rigorous tests by any means. The results will vary significantly, depending on a lot of factors. Also keep in mind that this is still not an ideal case, as the frame is captured outside the game, so there is still some overhead here. FSR implemented in-game should work better than that. So if you want to have a more fluid gaming experience without leaving it blurry, it is a very interesting solution, or as some people may say, a game changer. It works with any window, even with Notepad, media players, or even YouTube, you name it. The other methods of upscaling available are a bit heavier, so they are not recommended for gaming, but they are very interesting for other types of content. So this was a quick look of this tool, and I'm impressed. It definitely has potential. Maybe I could do more rigorous tests in the future. Anyway guys, as usual, I will leave the links to all the relevant material in the video description. Thanks for watching, and until the next time.